सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स मन की आल्टरनेट एकेडमिक कैलेंडर लो पार्ट का वी हैव टू लर्न वन मोर थ्योरम इन अवर 10th क्लास रियल नंबर्स दैट इज फंडामेंटल थ्योरम ऑफ अर्थमेटिक एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशंस जस्ट वी विल मूव ऑन टू दैट व्हाट इज अ फंडामेंटल अर्थमेटिक थ्योरम सो एवरी कंपोजिट नंबर कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड एज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ प्राइम्स एंड दिस फैक्टराइजेशन इज यूनिक apart from the order in which the prime factors occur. This means that we can write every composite number. So we have only division like prime numbers and composite numbers. So whatever the composite number is there, just we will take that composite number and that can be expressed as product of primes. That is the first thing we have to, that is the first point in the theorem that we have to concentrate. It should be a expressed as product of primes. And the second one is this factorization is unique apart from the order in which the prime factors occur. To understand this point, I will give you with an example. For example, if you want to factorize 144 with prime numbers, so I will start with 2. 2 cancelling 72 times, again 2 cancelling 36 times, again 2 cancelling 18 times, and 2 cancelling 9 times, and 3 cancelling 3 times. So this can be written as 144 can be written as 2 to the power of 4 into 3 square. Now this also can be written as 3 square into 2 power 4. If you observe these two, here first I have taken 2 and then 3. Here first I have taken 3 and then 2. So here order is, if you immature the order, if you didn't take into consideration, then we can say that this is unique because we have only 2 and 3 in this prime factorization. Here also only 3 and 2 in its prime factorization. So apart from the order in which the prime factors occur, this factorization is unique. That means there is no another way to write this if you didn't mention about the order. So if you write 2 power 4 into 3 square, 3 square into 2 power 4, if you didn't mention the order, this is unique. Only 2 and 3 will be there. I will give you with another example also so that you can understand more clear. That is, if you take another example, 30, if you take the 30, somebody can write 30 as 2 into 3 into 5, or 2 into 5 into 3, or 3 into 5 into 2, or 3 into 2 into 5. So here you can, if you observe this, the things, this 2 into 3 into 5, 2 into 5 into 3, 3 into 5 into 2, and 3 into 2 into 5. This is, order is different, but prime numbers are the same. So that's what I am mentioning, that this 2 into 3 into 5 will be the unique order. Unique, if you mention only the ascending order, this will be the unique way of representation of composite numbers. So this is the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Every composite number can be expressed as product of primes, and this factorization is unique apart from the order in which the prime factors occur. If you decide to write only in the ascending order, we will get only one thing, one unique answer, so that we can say this is unique. This is the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Now we'll go with applications of fundamental theorem. So that is finding LCM and HCF. If you go with an example, 12 and 18. First, I will write 12 as a prime factors as before. So 2 12s, 2 6, 2 3s. So 12 can be written as 2 square into 3. And then 18, 2 cancel 9 times, and 3, 3 times. So 18 can be written as 3 square into 2. Now, what is LCM? Here, LCM is nothing but you have to take all the factors in both. So all the factors means I have 2 and 3. Remember, we have to write all the factors, all the factors for LCM, all factors, and the highest powers. See, this 2 and 2 is there, the highest power is 2 here, so I have to take 2, power is 2. And 3 and 3, highest power is 2 here, so I have to take highest power. So finally the answer will be 2 square into 3 square. Here all factors I have to take. So while taking HCF, what I have to take is only the common things. I have to take only common letter, because 2, 2 is common, and 3, 3 is common. I have to take common and the least powers. The least power here 1 and here 1. So least power is 1. So I have to take the least powers 1 2 power 1 into 3 power 1, I will get 6 as the HCF. So remember, for LCM I have to take all factors and the highest powers, HCF common factors and least powers, that should be multiplied to get our LCM and HCF. If you take another example, 30 and 12, so 30 can be written as 2 into 3 into 5, 12 can be written as 2 square into 3. Now LCM, all factors I have to write, 2, 3, 5, I have to write all factors, and the highest power for 2 is 2, 3 is 1, so 5 is 5. So this will be the LCM, and HCF will be the only common factor. I should not take here 5 I cannot take, I take only 2 and 3 and their least powers. So least power is 1, here also 1, so I will take this one. So you have to remember, by using fundamental theorem of arithmetic, we can find LCM and HCF by taking all the powers, all the factors and the highest powers for LCM, and all only common factors and the least powers for HCF. So by this you have to complete this work for this week. Find the HCM and LCF for the following given pairs of numbers by prime factorization. Numbers are 120, 90, 50, 60, 37, 49 and 12, 15, 21. Even the three numbers we have to apply the same formula, same method. 17, 23, 29 and 8, 9, 25. Similarly, 72 and 108, 306 and 657. So express each of the following numbers as product of prime factors. Those are 140, 156, 3825, 5005, 7429. So second one you have to write only product of prime factors, and first one you have to do LCM and HCF. So this is the work for alternate academic calendar second week. So wish you good luck, stay home, stay safe and keep learning mathematics. Thank you one and all. Thank you.